Alright. I guess we are good to go. So, hello everyone. Welcome to CGRA, and this is Mikrish. So, Blender 2.92 is out with a lot of new features, improvements, and hell a lot of bug fixes. Out of all these, this is what I'm most interested in. Blender 2.92 is faster than ever before. Well, ever since 2.92 was out, I've been testing it on various factors like render, animation, and stability, etc. So, before getting into this video, the reason why we think Blender 2.92 is like a really good milestone is because recently, since we are into production and time is really crucial because render times are very important. And we were thinking of moving on to either Blender Octane or Unreal for final rendering. We thought Octane is a bit faster. So, and it was a bit faster too. But now 2.92 might be a really good deal, and let's see why. So, I'm using an AMD Ryzen 7 2700X processor and 32 gigs of RAM and NVIDIA RTX 2060 60GB card. And I'm using all these demo files from Blender official website as they are a bit more optimized, and all the links are down in the description below. So we will be running a number of tests based on various criteria. We'll talk about all those things as we go on. So I have arranged the videos in the ascending order of difference. So if you want to know the real deal about Blender 2.92, you might have to wait till the end of this video. So make sure you watch the entire video. The left one is for the results on Blender 2.91 and the right is for Blender 2.92, and both are running on the same system. So to start off with, I took an EEVEE scene here with both versions having exact same settings with 64 samples, and this is fairly a very simple scene with fewer lights and has a good amount of polygons, by the way. So we just rendered the single frame and it took around 23 seconds in 2.91 and around 19 seconds in 2.92. Where Blender 2.92 was just 4 seconds ahead of its previous version. So we plan to go for a couple of different scenes, so to check if we could really get any significant difference in their performance. So we opened up this tree creature scene and rendered a single frame, and to our surprise, both versions rendered in just 2 seconds. So the difference was really very minor. It was the same with the forest scene too, which even had particles, by the way. So both versions just rendered in just a second, with version 9.1 rendering in 1.16 seconds and version 9.2 rendering in 1.25 seconds. And we also noticed that each time the timing was different, even when the render when we rendered the same frame. So we thought that was a bit weird, so we decided to go for a batch render. So here are the results, by the way. So the tree creature scene, which was around 1000 frames, took around 38 minutes on version 2.91 with an average of 2.28 seconds per frame and 26 frames rendered per minute. With 2.92, it took the exact same 38 minutes to render the 1000 frames. So we couldn't really notice any difference. But on the forest scene, which is around 350 frames, it took around 8 minutes and 6 seconds with an average of 1.38 seconds per frame on version 2.91. And with 2.92, it took around 6 minutes and 45 seconds with an average of 1.15 seconds per frame. Well, on the whole, it looks like there isn't a much notable difference in terms of EEVEE, even though there is a slight improvement in terms of rendering speed. So, what about Blender 2.92 then? So that's it, not faster compared to the previous versions? Well, that's where it took us by surprise when we started testing with Cycles. We took this demo scene from Blender animated short Spring by the Blender Foundation itself, both versions running with GPU and with 300 samples and full HD 1080. So the reason why we took this particular scene is that the clothing texture, which had lots of nodes to calculate, and the hair system on girl and the dog. Well, as we expected, both versions slowed down a little bit while rendering the cloth portion alone because it had a lot of nodes to calculate. But it looks like the guys have worked a really lot on the hair system, as it significantly reduced the rendering time while rendering the hair alone. We could notice the hair rendering much faster in 2.92 than in 2.91. Overall, it took around 6 minutes 51 seconds on 2.91 and 5 minutes 55 seconds on 2.92, which is 1 minute difference per frame. That is 14% faster than 2.91. So, 14% faster, is that the deal? Well, that's not it. It took us much by surprise with our next test, where we tested this classroom scene. This is a typical Blender render test scene. So, how better was 2.92? Well, it took around 4 minutes and 23 seconds in 2.91 and 2 minutes and 52 seconds in 2.92, which is almost 1.5 times faster. 34% faster than the previous version. 34% faster? That was a pretty good deal. Well, that's not the end of the story too. We have more. Well, we want to test with an architectural render and we got some astonishing results. By the way, all these scenes are available from the link description below, so you can just check those things out. Now back to the ArcVis. It took around 6 minutes and 51 seconds to render on the latest version, that is 2.92, and it took around 13 minutes and 49 seconds on 2.91, where 2.92 was twice as fast as 2.91. That was really good. We weren't expecting this kind of a result, first of all. So we thought, let's put a scene where there is a lot of lighting information to be calculated, because we thought like architecture is kind of, you know, it wasn't that much high poly and wasn't there that much of lights and shadows to be calculated. So we thought, let's put a scene where there is a lot of lighting information to be calculated. So we decided to test this junkyard scene. It has lots of objects, more number of polygons, lot of light and shadow calculations to be done. So, also a variety of materials too, yeah. So, again, the results were amazing. 2.91 rendered in 2 minutes and 18 seconds and 2.92 at just 45 seconds. That was amazing. More than 3 times faster. Incredible results, right? Well, this was super exciting. And every time we just kept running these tests, we got some really amazing results. So, we just kept going on and on. And we just have one last scene for testing with cycles. This demo scene from Blender Animated Short, film Agent 327, we preferred this scene as we thought this scene could be a bit more complex as it has particles, smoke, hair system, etc. So with 2.91, it was a fairly complex scene, so it took some time. So we thought this could be like 1.5 times or 2 times faster with Blender 2.92. It took 3 minutes and 28 seconds in version 2.92 and 22 minutes and 31 seconds in 2.91, which was 6.5 times faster. We never expected this kind of result. Imagine if you're rendering this shot for about 100 frames, it might take approximately 36 hours to 37 hours in 2.91, but whereas with 2.92 it might take only 6 hours. That is a huge time saving performance improvement, because when you're into production, that is like amazing results. So, really starting to love 2.92 now. Well, Blender has mentioned that they've improved a lot in terms of overall performance, not just rendering. So, we thought like, let's put everything into test. So, I decided to test this physics engine of Blender 2.92. So, just a quick peek, we got some incredible results there too. Actually, 2.91 was better. We didn't expect that. So it took around 7 minutes and 23 seconds to bake this fluid simulation in 2.91, and in Blender 2.92 it took around 8 minutes and 55 seconds, almost 9 minutes. We couldn't believe that, so we thought, like, how is it even possible? Because so far 2.92 has been like really faster. So we decided to run the same test a couple of more times, but nope, every single time we got the same result. So let's move on to the next one, that is physics collisions. Well, whatever you see on this screen right now is real time. I've added this timer just to show you that, so it's actually real time. Blender 2.92 was much smoother and faster in terms of calculating collisions. Well, 2.91 was running at an average of 25 to 30 FPS. Whereas 2.92 was much smoother and was running at 70 to 80 frames per second. You can clearly notice the speed between 2.91 and 2.92, and the timeline is playing in loop, so you can see 2.92 is much faster and much ahead. Clearly, 2.92 is at least twice faster than 2.91 when it comes to collisions. So, now it's time for some animation, so we decided to go for animation test. We tested this animation playback speed on real time in both grayscale and as well as texture and lighting mode in EEVEE. So in 2.91, the grayscale mode, the animation was playing at average 13 frames per second, and in 2.92 it was playing much smoother at 25 frames per second on average. But in terms of texture and lighting mode on EEVEE, 2.91 was playing at 11 frames per second. There was a little bit of a drop in the frames, and you can clearly notice some jitters and lags in 2.91, whereas in 2.92 it was playing at 17 frames per second. On both scenarios, 2.92 was much faster than 2.91. However, we have one little thing to mention here. That is, the difference between the grayscale mode and the texture mode on 2.91, the frame rate difference was around 2 to 3 frames. But whereas in 2.92, there was a huge drop of about 8 frames between the texture and the grayscale mode. So that is something which has to be noted. But however, overall, the Blender 2.92 was much faster than its previous versions. Well, this is so far only based on our own observation so far, and there are a lot more improvements in 2.92, like the GeoNodes, hair system, and a lot more to cover. But this is something, the rendering speed and the overall performance was much faster. That is something was really exciting for me, because it really helps a lot with production. Because at the end of the day, time is everything. So we haven't faced any stability issues so far, because it's just been a few weeks now, and maybe on a longer run we will definitely get to know if we have any other improvements or issues. So for now, it looks like Blender is much faster than its previous versions. I guess that's it for this session, guys, and stay tuned for more updates on CGI. Don't forget to subscribe to CGRA if you too think that Blender 2.92 is faster now. So, see you guys with another episode. Until then, see you guys, and this is me, Krish, signing off. Bye-bye.